On December 8, 1953, President Eisenhower went before the UN General Assembly to discuss the growing danger behind the possibility of atomic warfare. I believe that President Eisenhower is trying to calm the world down and assure us that another Hiroshima or Nagasaki will never happen again. Throughout the speech, Eisenhower assured the delegates of the assembly that there are other peaceful ways to utilize nuclear energy. We all know the danger of communism is a major threat to our capitalistic way of life, so in a way, Eisenhower's speech, Atoms for Peace, was simply just a way to comfort an already distressed society. Communism is still a major threat to our way of life, even though the Korean War is over.
Wake up! tell me who's watching? Who's watching me?
Outdoors every day. Think how much dust and dirt settle on your skin. And makeup clings to your skin, too, and clogs pores. That's why your face needs a thorough cleansing each day. And that's why cleansing tests were made by an independent testing laboratory. This same kind of dirt was made just radioactive enough to register on a Geiger counter. Leading cleansing creams, complexion soaps, and Dorothy Gray Salon Cold Cream were used to remove this dirt. The Geiger counter proved that Dorothy Gray Salon Cold Cream cleanses up to 2.5 times more thoroughly than any soap or other cleansing cream tested. When you cleanse with Dorothy Gray Salon Cold Cream, you know you remove dirt. And more important, you remove every trace of makeup which can clog your pores. That's why Salon Cold Cream is especially recommended for a young complexion. A clean skin is a healthy skin, and your skin will look smoother and clearer when you use Dorothy Gray Salon Cold Cream. It's so quick and easy, too. Takes no more time than improper cleansing. For particulars of this Geiger counter story, write for this test booklet to Dorothy Gray Limited, Box 18, Grand Central Station, New York City.
Hey Mary Lou, I painted this in art class for you the other day.
Really? Did you paint that for me?
Well, not exactly. It's only a replica. I had to size it down because it was really 18 feet long. See, here it is.
Well, what's the picture about?
Well, the actual artist's name is Barnett Newman. The name of the canvas is Ver Heroicus Sublimus. Well, the painting was about communism and how it spread all over Asia.
Communism. Poor Eisenhower. I'm just beginning to realize what his problems are. Well, that's sweet of you. I wrote this poem for you. It's called Korea, the Chosen Place. Korea, the chosen place, ravished by war, laid to waste. All United Nations there engaged in another history page. Korea, 'tis not a beauty sight to see by day or by night. The eye beholds only the gloom of a country buried in a war's tomb. Korea, it's been torn up and torn down, marched up and marched down. Korea, bloodshed, land and mountains, have been bathed by youthful fountains. Brave men here have gone to their reward, perished neath this sword. Korea, 'twas not a war, they say, only a police action day by day, a testing place for the human race. Korea, two ideals clashing, communism and democracy smashing, the UN's firm stand against the hammer red hand. Korea, a question of peace there, a question of peace everywhere. Soon it may be inflamed, again in blood and war's shame. Korea, a prayer of the free, that in peace here we may see the sword no more to rise on any land or any skies.
Oh my God, that was beautiful. Did you really write that, Mary Lou?
Well, actually I saw it in the newspaper. I thought you might like it.
Oh yeah, that's the poem written by Irvin Warden.
Yeah, the poem was included in the book Korea, the Chosen Place, A View from Old Smoky. I think the poem was, like, based on all the problems that Eisenhower was having during the Korean War.
Well, Poor Eisenhower. I mean, I'm just beginning to realize what his problems are. We're already here, so let's get going.
Okay, let's go.
So my mom was telling me that this movie was based on H.G. Wells' novel, War of the Worlds.
Yeah, did you hear about that radio broadcast in the 30s that it was based on?
Oh yeah, wasn't there a giant scare because people actually thought they were being invaded by aliens?
Yeah.
Man, poor Eisenhower. I'm just beginning to realize what his problems are.
I know. I heard this movie was like 6 years old, but I heard it was really good.
Yeah, didn't it win like an Oscar?
Yep, Byron Haskin did a really good job.
Alright, the news is starting.
Outside Havana's presidential palace, hundreds of thousands rally at the call of revolutionary leader Fidel Castro, who estimated their number at 1 million. Most of the throng wears the colors of Castro's 26th of July movement. They are in an exultant mood as the man who overthrew the Batista dictatorship calls on them to approve the public trials and executions of pro-Batista figures guilty of war crimes and atrocities. The executions, some 250 to date, have been widely criticized by many as too hasty and summary, even if justified. Says Castro, the Cuban Revolutionary Government has no reason to offer explanations to America or to anyone except the people of Cuba. Castro asks his audience if it favors the summary court-martial and gets his answer in a roar of approval. Cuba has spoken. Despite outside protests, the executions will continue.
Jeepers!
Communism is right in our front yard.
Poor Eisenhower. I'm just beginning to realize what his problems are.
World War, and for the first time in the history of man, nations combined to fight against nations using the crude weapons of those days. The Second World War involved every continent on the globe, and men turned to science for new devices of warfare, which reached an unparalleled peak in their capacity for destruction. And now, fought with the terrible weapons of super science, menacing all mankind and every creature on Earth, comes the War of the Worlds.
And it goes a little something like this.